The Godox SL60W is the go-to light for any video creator on a budget, and here's what you need to know about this light. Obviously, the first thing you want to know is what comes in the box. Well, you get the light, you get a power cable, a remote control, and some kits even include a honeycomb, barn doors, and colored gels. This light offers a bright source of light with a Bowens mount for the common softbox. The cost is a mere fraction of the competing lights coming in around $120 to $140 US. The color of this light is 5600K, so when you're setting your white balance, that's exactly where to go, which is really similar to a big, beautiful, bright window at midday. So I've heard from some other video creators that when using this light, they struggle a bit with capturing fan noise in the audio, and obviously you don't want that. But as someone who has used similar cost-effective budget lights like this, such as the Amran 100X, honestly, the SL60 is far superior in fan noise, especially like the Amran series. It just runs into a lot of tone humming issues and stuff that's really hard to remove from your audio compared to the SL60, which is just a really soft fan. It doesn't have any tones or humming or buzzing, which is really not that hard to deal with. If you're running into this issue, I suggest checking out my video about audio tips and how to get great audio, because it might actually be more related to how you're capturing your audio than it is the problem with the light. The CRI on the SL60 is 93, which is pretty good for color accuracy. While it does come up a little bit inaccurate compared to some other more expensive and awesome high quality lights, 93 CRI is really good. The only thing you might run into is having to color grade a little bit by shifting to the magenta or shifting towards the green. And generally with LED lights, the older they get, they suffer from shifting no matter how expensive they are. So it's really something that's not too big of a deal as long as it doesn't get too crazy. As someone who has used this light for several years and on lots of different types of shoots for photo and video use, here are some issues that I've personally run into. The output range of the SL60 is 100% down to 10%. Now, I don't know why it stops at 10%, but you can't dim any further without turning the light off. It's pretty easy to get around this. Just use your honeycomb grid, barn doors, or layers of diffusion to make the light dimmer if you're trying to get underneath 10%. While I personally haven't struggled with getting the light dimmer, there have been a couple scenarios where I needed more light. For instance, I tried to light a subject one time against this really big, beautiful, bright window, and it just wasn't enough to compete with the sun, obviously. So what I suggest is getting the SL100 and spend a few more bucks and get it in the bicolor option. If you want to check out that light, I have a video on that that I'll link in the cards here and at the end of this video. So the last little issue that I want to note about the SL60 is that the build quality is a little cheaper than competitors, but it's also a little bit more cost effective. So if you're someone who's really tough on your gear, let me just suggest investing in a nice bag or case to tote this thing around. Or if you're someone who's just setting it up in a studio, this is a perfect light for you. So if you're in the market for a good video light, I've linked this light as well as some other options down in the description for you to check out. While you scroll down there, don't forget to like the video because it really does help the channel. Consider subscribing if you enjoyed this video. And as always, you know I gotta say it, stay creative. See ya.